Welcome. In this video, we'll be looking at an overview of OnPatient and how it can be used to connect with your provider. Let's start with how we can sign up for OnPatient. Your provider's office will send an invitation to your email to sign up. The invitation is valid for 7 days once it has been emailed to you. We can click Sign Up Now to begin the process. Once you've been taken to the OnPatient website, the first step will be to verify your information and create a password. Once your password has been created, you can click Sign Up. The next step is to enter your date of birth and phone number that you provided to the office and click Confirm. Once you're in OnPatient, we can check in for an appointment. To check in for an appointment, you can click on the check-in button next to the upcoming appointment. We cannot check in for past appointments. Once we are at the onboarding forms, we can enter the information that we need for the office. The amount of information that is already here may vary depending on how much information you've given to the office. At minimum, it should have your first name, last name, date of birth, phone number, and email. Just as with paper forms, it's important to complete as much information as possible for your patient record. You can go through and enter reasons for visit. You can add any emergency contact information, any changes to medications or allergies. You can make notes for that for the practice to review. You can add insurance information. If you're not the subscriber, there's a checkbox to add the subscriber's information. And then you can sign consent forms. To sign the consent form, simply click on the consent form, scroll through, and say, I've read this document, add your signature and save, and then click I'm done, and you're finished. Let's take a look at some other appointment features that are available in OnPatient. Under the appointment menu, you can view and access appointment information. To view an appointment, simply click on the link to see the appointment details. When you click on the link, it'll open up another screen. We can see this is a past appointment, so there's not much we can do with it. But if we click on an upcoming appointment, we have a few options, provided that they've been enabled by the practice. If you need to reschedule an appointment, you can click Reschedule, and the schedule will open up. You can select a time, and another window will open up. Click Reschedule, and Confirm. You will then be prompted to check into the appointment. So again, fill out all the information necessary, go through the process, sign the consent forms, and once that's complete, you're done. You can also cancel an appointment by navigating to the appointment, clicking cancel, and this feature does have to be enabled by the practice. You'll enter your reason for cancellation and then click OK. And you'll get confirmation and you won't see that in your upcoming appointments. You can also book appointments online if enabled by the practice. Simply navigate to the Book Appointment button, select a provider, and then a location. Next, you'll select a time, and this will prompt you to enter a reason for visit, which is required. Once you've entered that, click Schedule and Confirm. The next step is to complete the onboarding for the appointment. Go through and fill out as much information as possible, especially anything relevant to this appointment, and click I'm done, and you're set. You can also send messages to your provider or their office. Simply navigate to the Messages menu and click Send Message. Next, select the recipient, enter a subject, and then the body of your message. You can also add any attachments by dragging and dropping them to the box or selecting the files for upload to be included with the message. Once you have entered all of the information and you have everything that you need, click Send Message, and you're set. When your provider responds, you'll get an email notification. Click on the link in the email to be taken to OnPatient. You can click on the message to access it and view the response. You can click Reply, and from there, it's just like doing an email chain. The practice may also share educational materials with you. Then you'll get an email notification that you have new documents to view on OnPatient. Simply click on the link, and you'll be taken to the Documents section. Click on the document to view, and from here you can print or download. The document will be available in your Documents section on OnPatient. Through OnPatient, you can also view statements and make payments. To do so, you'll navigate to the Billing tab, where there'll be three sections: Statements, Payment History, and Payment Methods. Under Payment Methods, you can add a card to keep on file or to make payments if you would like. Simply enter the card information and click Save Card. It'll ask you if you're sure and click Yes. Once you've done so, you can see your card information on file and use it to make payments. To make a payment, simply click Make Payment and you can enter payment information. You can enter one-time payment information or also use a card on file. You can enter card information, also enter the billing information. At any point in time, you can always click Use Save Card if you have a card on file. Once you have entered all the information, click Pay. The practice may also send you statements. You will get an email notification of that you have a new statement available in OnPatient. You can click Sign in to OnPatient to view it. Once you click on the link, you'll be taken to the billing section, and you can see that we have a statement. If you want to view the statement, simply click View, and then you can see what the charges are. In OnPatient, you can click Pay, and you can use a card on file, or do one-time payment information. Click Pay, and once you're set, confirm, and the payment will process, and you'll be all set. Once the payment is complete, you can navigate to Payment History to see a record of the transaction. If you have any questions, you can contact the practice about the payment. You can also access your health profile, and we'll also talk about some OnPatient settings. To access your health profile, go to the Health Profile tab, and there'll be several sections here. You'll see any diagnosed problems, any documented allergies, and any medications and interactions. Lab results can also be shared with you. You can see the results here. You can also see your complete health profile. Your health profile is going to be a copy of your personal health record with the practice. You can download a copy of it as a PDF. Simply click Download PDF. It'll take just a second. And once it's downloaded, you can view your health record. You can also email or download a copy of a CCDA file of your personal health record. CCDA means Consolidated Clinical Document Architecture, which is a specific file type for electronic medical records. Within this document, you can click on the different areas underneath the table of contents to navigate to the specific sections that you would like to view of your health record. Let's look at some of the settings that we have with OnPatient. To get to the settings menu, simply click on your name. And here you can see your email address, name, and if you needed to make any updates, you could do that here as well. You can also designate any representatives. Representatives are other OnPatient users that represent you or that you can represent. To add a representative, simply enter their email address, and once you have that in there, you can click Submit. And once the person has been added, they will appear under your representatives menu. If you need to remove a representative, just click Remove. You can also see the people who you represent here as well, and you can click on their name to access their record. Once you're all set with OnPatient, if you need to log out, click on the arrow next to your name, and you're all set. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video.